Income tax season is done a little bit differently in Hyrule. Instead of sending you a check, they hide it in a dungeon, make you fight a boss for it. That way, only the adventurers get paid. Welcome back to freshly picked Tingle's Rosy Rupeeland. We ended the first dungeon of the game, the Hero Shrine, and we killed ourselves a Beetle Lord Deathbug for huge prizes. Now nothing's stopping us from getting to Rupeeland. Look at all those rupees I got. But I'm not gonna throw all of them into the pool. I need some spending money when I get to Rupeeland. So we're gonna throw in 650 rupees instead. Save the rest of it when I get there. Alright, show me that Rupeeland. Anytime now! Is that the portal opening? Nope, Tingle just supernovaed everyone. What the heck is this going on? This isn't Rupeeland! That's definitely not a Rupeeland. That wasn't a pool of water at all, it was a tower. What do you mean, level one? Uncle Rupee, I think I broke it. Please help. Oh, Uncle Rupee's looking a little bit more together. At least he's wearing clothes this time. He upgraded from a Rupee hobo to a Rupee salaryman. This pool is actually one giant tower. Keep on giving it rupees and it'll keep growing. It'll take us all the way up to Rupeeland. Our mission has just begun. This thing's only 3 meters tall. It's kind of dinky. Okay, what am I going to see off of a 3 meter tall tower? Who is playing the mouth harp, I ask you? It ain't Uncle Rupee. Getting ridiculous in here. Yeah, how do I get such a view from only 3 meters up anyway? I mean, shouldn't I only be seeing tops of trees? Well, kinda. I also feel cheated at the same time, too, so... Now we could go to faraway places from the top of this tower. Where can we go at only 3 meters height? I'll probably just hurt myself a little. What do you mean faraway places anyway? I'll just land in my backyard. Not this sunshine seashore place. But of course, Tingle has his trusty balloon handy. I always thought that was some kind of gadget he invented. But nope, it's part of his Tingle powers. And here's Pinkle again. She's not only our secretary, she's also done some Wikipedia work on these areas. She'll give us the lowdown when we land in a new area. Here, the town is nearby, and it looks pretty safe, but you're still Tingle, so be careful. Now it's time to do some exploring! What the heck is that guy? Exploring has been set aside, I want to find out who that is. And also Abba is up there, she wants me to enroll in something again, I bet. I heard that! I got big ears, you know, I'm a Hylian. The heck was that? Hey buddy, what was that thing? Tell me all about it. This is a shakedown, isn't it? I bet that was something really important that I'm gonna want. Ah, fine. I have no choice but to pay you. You'll mug me or something. This is how we get our maps in the game. We have to find this guy, who I like to call the Look What I Found Kid, because that's exactly what he says when he finds a map. I'm gonna learn to hate him so much. But at least we got a map now, we can start making money off of it. And maybe we should talk to Abba for a bit. What are we gonna do today, Abba? Yeah, I'm not dead. I surprised you. I fought a boss and everything. Aren't you proud of me? No, you're putting words in my mouth. I remember everything. In fact, I think I could teach you some things. Those were just toys that time. Now it's for the real deal. I'm taking this training session merely because, hey, it's free items. Yeah, and I love when they do so. Sometimes they spill rupees, too. That's pretty fun. The more boss enemies you fight, the more items you get. That's pretty much the name of this tutorial right here. Most important thing is footwork. You're always obsessed about that footwork. We're gonna have to have a little talk about that. Alright, she wants to see how tingly I've gotten. Time to fight one enemy, right in front of her. See that? I knocked the bones right out of him. If we only battle one monster, we only get one item. Alright, now for the real tutorial. Multiple enemies, multiple items. Can you get a bonanza? You have to fight them all at once. No bodyguard. This is the ultimate test of your tingling knowledge. I'll tingle them so hard they don't know it's coming. I'm the master of the tingle. And luckily these enemies are aggressive, so they'll run into you instead of try to run away from you. It's a lot harder to do when they run away. Look at all these items I spilled out of them. I'm an expert. I don't think I need you anymore, Abba. You got anything important to teach me? Otherwise, get out of my way. I need to collect this stuff. Yeah, a bodyguard would be helpful. Tingle doesn't really get any stronger. He doesn't find, like, a master rupee that gives him super rupee powers. Alright, see you later. We'll never see Abba again. So that see you later is just to get you out of my hair. So we should look into that battle partner thing as soon as possible. Get all the tutorials out of the way. Tingle has learned more battle skills. Now he has more Kokiri badges, so he has all of his combos. Now we're kind of free to explore. Like this thing. This ain't it on the map. It's just an empty space here. I will solve this problem. I'm not going to try and draw shells anymore. I just want to circle it. It's the shell mound! Now to learn a thing about landmarks that aren't on Hometown Prairie. They'll always spew items, like this seaweed. But that only happens the first time you click on them. They won't spew items anymore otherwise. There's some areas you can collect multiple items from and come back later and get more, but those aren't really landmarks. Danger! This is a very dangerous area. Don't mess with that monster over there with the googly eyes. He'll tear you wide open. So, what can we do to solve that? Tingle, I told you to never make that noise. He makes that noise when you click on something and he's too far away from it. I'm gonna have problems with those rock monsters. But not these things, though. This is my favorite place to go and get minced meat. We're gonna need that later. And this is the best place to get it. Look at all that meat. Look at all those bones. Look at all those rupees. Also, I don't know what that thing was up there, but that's not the day for this. This sign insulted me. I don't want to mess with this sign anymore. I will destroy this thing because it's coming after me. And if anybody ever said when pigs fly, well, there you go. There's the pig that flies. Show him it one day. The top bodyguards. Now you got me sold. I'm going to check out these bodyguards now. Hey, look at this guy. He kind of looks like a Sub-Rosian from the Oracle of Seasons and that other game that had Oracle in it that I can't remember. Yes, I do. Do you have Teddy Toto? I'm looking for a Teddy Toto. This is the bodyguard salon. Whenever you reach a new area, look for this symbol that's right on the map. Let me move down a little bit so I can show you on the main map. That big red and yellow symbol of the guy doing a flexi pose. You go in here to find your bodyguards. But this place is kind of going to tutorial at us a little bit too. I kind of don't like it. But this guy has some important information in a tutorial. Those pigs that are flying around. They actually have some fur on them. And you could take that fur and sell it for a good profit. There's several items you could do that with. Not just fur, but also feathers and gemstones, so you could sometimes knock out of enemies. Very useful for making money. And this place. I think I walked into a cult situation. Yep, it's indeed a cult. They have uniforms and everything. I see through your guys. It ain't a club at all. No, I think I should be leaving. Oh. Okay, it isn't a cult after all. It's the official bodyguard fan club. These guys know everything about bodyguards, but I kinda told you them all already. These guys have information on bodyguards like about their health, about their different stats, about if they get knocked out in battle you have to hire them back and such like that. This guy has something we didn't talk about yet. Special abilities. It's kind of top secret information. This guy doesn't have a lot of information on it either. But each individual bodyguard has their own special skills. and they don't have to involve battling. Like small bodyguards, they have certain advantages, which, like, they could fit into spaces even Tingle can't get into. Big bodyguards can move things, and medium-sized bodyguards are really good lockpicks. They can open locks that Tingle cannot. So it's not just a combat thing, they actually help you solve some puzzles, too. And of course, when you're in a smoke cloud with your bodyguard, you could tap on it. You'll give them additional power, and something special might happen too. It's a very random chance though. Some bodyguards have better chances than others. And you can't really hire them here. They're kind of special. These are bodyguards. Each of these guys is their own class. Any bodyguard I don't hire, I'll put up, you know, their rupee values, what their qualities are, maybe their name if I feel like it. Those guys will just tell us more about bodyguards, so just talk to the proprietor of this little shop. Come on, buddy, I don't have all day, I just want one of your minions. Give me a minion. Yes, it is, but it's not my first time playing it. I kinda explained most of what this shop's about. This is where you come to pay for your bodyguards. This guy will take a commission, though, so be careful. These bodyguards don't accept your offer the first time through. He'll give you your rupees back. Each of these bodyguards have their own prices. And if they don't take your offer, you still lose your commission. And the commission will increase as the levels go on. So I'm gonna hire this little guy right here for 10 rupees. And we get to have a talk with him. And he won't come with us unless we offer him 45 rupees. This is Titch, he's a small bodyguard. And he's rather aggressive, which is what I like in my minions. Actually, I like the assertive kind of best, but there's none available today. We'll get to that a little bit later. Alright, we got a new minion! He's not quite a Teddy Toto, but he'll do. He'll do indeed. See? He's even on our list. We don't need to find every bodyguard to 100% this game. But it's fun to see all of the little bios that they have going on. He's not as strong as Teddy, he has the same defense, and he definitely doesn't have as much health. Teddy was kind of a special character anyway. So, next time on Freshly Picked Tingle's Rosy Rupeeland... Oh, he has more to say at us. Come on, I'm trying to wrap it up here. Yeah, they might be loyal minions, but they won't follow us around forever. If their hearts run out, that'll be the end of their contract and they'll fall over. But there's some ways to get around that. You could go up and you could pay them again to renew their contract, or you could find some items that'll be able to heal them before that happens. Or you can just abandon them. You got options. Okay, anybody else want to teach me about this game that I obviously played before? Huh? Anyone? Out of the way, Titch. I need to check behind here. There might be someone jumping out. Alright. I think it's safe. Next time on Freshly Picked Tingle's Rosy Rupeeland, we're going to explore more of this seashore place. Find some landmarks. Maybe we'll find a place that has a great amount of rupees, like that last area was. Good night, folks.